Fort Worth City Band is here to bring you an old-fashioned band concert in the park. My name is Mike Malloy, and I have the uncommon good fortune to be the maestro of these magnificent, mellifluous, musical minstrels and masters of melody, modern and medieval, mellow and martial. My friends, the Fort Worth City Band. Opening number was that exciting old circus march, Barnum and Bailey's favorite, written by a man named Carl King, a great circus bandmaster and composer of a few years ago. We're going to go ahead now with something completely different. It is said that the most beautiful word in the English language is home, and that's probably so. Especially to somebody who hasn't been there for a while. Especially to somebody who wonders what's different, what's changed, what stayed the same back at home. And maybe not so much in these days as a long time ago. Maybe someone who knows he's not going to see home again. Well, this song we're going to play is on that theme. It's a very beautiful ballad from a Broadway show called Finian's Rainbow, which opened in 1947, and is called How Are Things in Glaucomora.
Thank you. to try and recreate a really cherished American tradition of other time band concert. And imagine, if you will, someplace like Xenia, Ohio, Grover's Corners, New Hampshire, or Freeburn, Texas, on a warm summer's evening about 100 years ago. The town band in gaudy uniform is assembled on the memorial bandstand there next to the cannon donated by the GAR. The audience of town people out there on the benches, the wooden benches, under the sycamore trees, amidst the flash of fireflies and the hum of the mosquitoes. The ladies in their long skirts, their long hair piled up under their hats for coolness, the gentlemen in their straw hats and their sleeve garters. And you might keep an eye on that young fellow over there by the cannon, the one with the knickerbockers and the pea shooter. And now the bandmaster steps forward and announces the next number. It's going to be that old favorite, the overture to Rossini's Italian in Algiers. Now all attention is centered on the gazebo while the professor raises his baton. Well, almost all attention. There's a young couple over there in the shadows who don't seem to be paying any attention to the music at all.
Thank you.
Let me say that again. That was the Italian in Algiers Overture by Rossini with oboe work by Jeanette Hayhurst. And it ain't an easy instrument to play. We'll go now for a piece from an English composer a few years ago, a man by the name of Eric Coates. Eric Coates was a master of light orchestral music and song in the typically English fashion. He first made a name for himself with a piece called The London Suite, in which he described various parts of the metropolis, Covent Garden, Westminster, and the elegant Knightsbridge district. In 1933, the BBC Home Service introduced a new radio program called In Town Tonight. And for the theme music, they selected the Knightsbridge section from Eric Coates' work. Well, the show went on the first Saturday night, and before it was over, the switchboards were lit up and overwhelmed with people calling in wanting to know what that music was and who the composer was. And so Eric Coates became very famous overnight. In Town Tonight played every Saturday night on the BBC for 27 years, going off the air in 1960. And we'd like to play for you now the music that all the excitement was about. Here's Eric Coates' Knightsbridge March.
Thank you.
The composer of our next piece, Frank Meacham, was born in Buffalo in 1856 and published his first song at the age of 10. He grew up to publish quite a few more songs, waltzes, marches, and other pieces, all of which are forgotten today, with the exception of one piece, which just about everybody knows. Just about everybody knows the tune, that is. They may not know the title, they may not know the composer. It's been a hit at band concerts ever since it was introduced in 1891. And we'd like to give you another listen to it here tonight. Here's that old favorite, Frank Meacham's American Patrol.
Thank you.
control. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask Mr. Campbell to come back again. He won't be playing for you this time, but he'd like to tell you a few things about our band and what it is we're trying to do. Ira?
I don't need no stinky microphone. I'm full of hot air. Can't you tell that? I play cornet, trumpet, and I talk a lot about bears and the band. Anyway, I digress. I'm here to tell you about the Fort Worth City Band. We've been around since 1960, and we still have some of our original members here in our 45th year of performing for public pleasure. Are we having any pleasure out there, public?
Yeah.
All right. No, really. I know I am. I hope you are, too. This is great. I love it. Can't get enough of it. Anyway, we are designated by the Fort Worth City Council as the official band of the city of Fort Worth. And that's as far as their support goes. They don't budget us a dime. They don't give us nothing. They give us the ability to wear those patches that say Fort Worth on them. That's it. So, I am here to beg for money. Well, no, actually, I'm here to sell you bears. We have the Fort Worth, the official Fort Worth City Band bear. It's got a patch very similar in nature to the one I have on my very uniform shirt. And on the back, it says Fort Worth City Band, and it has a handy dandy phone number you could use to call us to come back and play here or wherever you'd like us to play. So we are selling these for the princely sum of $10. $10 a piece, and you can have a Fort Worth City Band bear and support us and our musical efforts. Okay, thank you much for your time and tolerance. I hope the microphones had a good rest.
Thank you, Ira. I hope your efforts were successful. We're going to go ahead now with the concert and something for those of you who like your music with a Spanish flavor. This is a Paso Doble, probably the most famous of all Paso Dobles. It's called Amparito Roca. And very exciting Spanish music. The laughing señoritas, the charming caballeros, the bullfight. Of course, it was probably written by an English composer. They're not quite sure of that. But I probably shouldn't have told you that because it surely does sound Spanish. Here is Amparito Roca. Thank you. In 1935 in Kansas City, there was a young fellow named Bill who had a band that was quite successful in a small way. They earned a place on the local radio station and were doing pretty well. One evening, just before the broadcast, the announcer came up to Bill and said, "I wonder if you'd mind if I introduced you a little differently. Your name of Bill is fine, but it's quite a common name, not something people might remember. Could I use something else?" Bill said, "Fine with me. As long as the paycheck is there, you can call me what you like." So he went on that night, leading what was announced as the Count Basie Orchestra. Well, Count Basie and his orchestra soon outgrew Kansas City. They went to New York, played in such places as Roseland, the Apollo Ballroom, and more importantly, won contracts on network radio. Well, for the next 40 years, the Basie Band was one of the best of the American jazz bands and set the standards. We're going to play for you a piece made famous by the Count Basie Orchestra now, and it's called Jumpin' at the Woodside. His Honor by Henry Fillmore. Well, that brings us to our featured piece of the evening. You know, the name of Victor Herbert is best known for all of his wonderful tuneful operettas, but this Irish-American composer was really quite talented in many different musical fields. He was born... Some selections from Victor Herbert operettas. ¶¶